Hi everyone, welcome. This is Dr. Susan Brown with Alkaline for Life. Today we're going to talk about three ways to dose vitamin C. Three different ways you can use to decide how much vitamin C you should be taking. But before we get into those three ways, let me just remind us a bit about why we're even talking about vitamin C. Vitamin C is the premier water-soluble antioxidant. It's the greatest electron donor in the body. It donates electrons to charge up every cell. It's like our little battery we can take in our body. It protects every cell with its antioxidant capacity, energizes every cell. It really is concentrated in the white blood cells, very essential for the immune system. The more challenge we have with infection and illness, the more vitamin C we need. Our vitamin C need greatly increases when we get health problems or when we're facing infection. And we're reminded that most every animal, and certainly all plants, and most every animal except fruit-eating bats and certain kinds of fishes and many primates, those are the animals that don't produce vitamin C. Most other animals do produce vitamin C in their very own bodies, and they produce much more vitamin C when they're challenged by illness. We have several examples of that I've written about. It's quite striking. So, vitamin C is extremely important for many, many reasons, and you can find this information on many of our blogs at Alkaline for Life. But the question comes up, how much vitamin C should I use? So I'm going to show you these three methods of dosing. Now, this is important because if I take vitamin C, I take 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C or 2,000 milligrams, it may last in my body an hour. In your body, it might last several hours, several days. Vitamin C has a half-life in the body, and that depends on the oxidative damage that's going on with the body. It depends on how much the antioxidant is used up. A healthy person may need a very small amount of vitamin C, and it's recycled in the body, lasts a long time. A person with allergies, health challenges, any kind of infectious challenge is going to use a lot of vitamin C. And we've written about different doctors who used vitamin C for all kinds of infections and challenges. And they started from very small doses, like Dr. Cathcart, a 20-gram cold up to 100 grams that might be used in a flu or influenza or even more. The half-life of vitamin C varies within the individual. And so I'm going to show you how to get a rough idea of how much you might need. The half-life varies, and the amount of vitamin C that you need at any given time can vary. So if you talk about the dosing mechanisms, the simplest one is what I call the basic gorilla approach. And that is, if we look at the higher primates, like the average gorilla is estimated to consume about 3,000 or 4,000 milligrams of vitamin C in their diet. Now, we're very closely related to the gorillas. So you could think, well, I'm about the same size as a gorilla. I'm going to eat as much vitamin C, I'm going to take as much vitamin C in supplements as I would get if I were that size of a gorilla. And this is actually what Linus Pauling, the famous Nobel laureate who worked so much with vitamin C and who did the groundbreaking work on vitamin C and cancer, that's what he decided. He said, let me start out with 3-4 grams because that's what the average gorilla my size would get, and we're pretty close relatives. So that's one way of doing it. And in fact, in clinical practice, we see that 3,000 or 4,000 milligrams, maybe a gram taken several times during the day, really most people tolerate it well. They don't get, it isn't too much for them, and they see it to be of great benefit. So that's one way to dose it, just to say, I'm going to use a common sense dose, take the amount of vitamin C that I would produce if I were an animal that produced vitamin C, and that's about 3 to 4 grams, depending on your size. Another way to do it was developed by Dr. Cathcart in the 1980s. This is a physician who treated 20,000 people with high-dose vitamin C. We're going to link you to a blog I wrote on him. And what he found out over his years of experience was that when people, the average person could easily take 5-6 grams of vitamin C, not get too much loose stool. But when a person was ill, they needed much more vitamin C. And in fact, this surprised him quite a bit. And he carefully documented how much vitamin C his clients could take when they were ill. And you can see those charts. It's pretty impressive. He actually developed a system called dosing to bowel tolerance. In other words, he had his clients take perhaps 1,000 or 2,000 milligrams of vitamin C at a time, and then would take it over the day until they got just about getting too much loose stool. When they started to get loose stool, he would stop there. That's called dosing to bowel tolerance. Many physicians still do it today. And that sort of guarantees that if you take it throughout the day, you have enough vitamin C to deal with any challenge that comes along. If you're extremely healthy, you will get a loose stool much quicker than if you have a significant health challenge or a significant antioxidant demand within the body, if there was a lot of oxidative damage going on. So that second way is called bowel tolerance. And it's a very effective way to do it. You can read some of the details if you want of how Dr. Cathcart and others did this. The third system is a little more sophisticated. It's called the vitamin C calibration or the vitamin C flush. Now, I'm not going to detail that procedure much here because we're going to do a separate blog on that and give you all separate instructions. But this is a system developed by Dr. Russell Jaffe, a current physician, a physician in the current age, who has really championed the use of high-dose vitamin C for healing and regenerating body health. And the system with the calibration is you actually take a certain amount of vitamin C several times, you know, during the day or within a few hours, and you see how long it takes you not only to get to bowel tolerance, but actually to have a complete flush, that you have like a colonic effect, like a watery stool. That serves to say, wow, I don't need this much vitamin C. I've had too much vitamin C. It serves to cleanse the colon, so it's very detoxifying. But then it tells you, this is the maximum amount, more than the maximum amount I could use. And so with the vitamin C calibration, you stop once you have the flush, and then you back off to 75%, let's say, of that dose in the following days. Like I said, this is a more complicated procedure. It takes you to a little higher dose of vitamin C. It's certainly used when people have major health concerns or they really want to maximize their health. We'll write a separate blog on that. And it's always good to do that technique, that vitamin C calibration, under the care of a health professional, because it's an unusual thing to do, and you want to get familiar with doing it with someone who has guided people in that before. So those are the three systems for calibrating and diagnosing to dosing vitamin C, let me say more properly. And if you ever wonder, you might say, well, I think I've got plenty of vitamin C. There's these little interesting vitamin C dipsticks that have a reagent that can detect vitamin C in the urine. So it's a simple thing. You just urinate on the stick and it'll tell you if you have some vitamin C in the urine. We always want to have some in the urine. That means we have enough in the body, so we have excess. Even though you have some in the urine, you're always going to be retaining a certain percentage of that, maybe 30 or 40% at least you're going to retain. So you want all through the day. I could take some vitamin C, have a high level. Now, in 5 hours, I might have a low level because I've used that up so quickly. Whatever you do, remember, we take vitamin C, we spread it throughout the day, even if you decide to do a moderate amount. If you're interested in calibrating or judging your own amount, consider our three dosing procedure that we just talked about. In the meantime, we'll be writing a lot about vitamin C and talking a lot about vitamin C. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Send us any questions and we'll be talking to you soon.